Welcome to the assembly instructions for the Brinkman Zone 5-in-1 Cooking System Gas Grill 2390. Choose a good, cleared assembly area and get a friend to help you put your grill together. Carefully remove the contents from the box and packaging. Use caution. Some parts may contain sharp edges. Inspect the contents of the box to ensure all parts are included and undamaged. Unfold the sides of the cart. Attach the tank holder to the cart by placing the keyholes over the pre-attached bolts on the bottom of the cart. Slide down into place and tighten securely. Remove the wing nut from the tank holder bracket bolt. Attach the tank holder to the tank holder bracket, then secure by using the wing nut. Turn the cart over and attach each locking caster using the hex nut wrench. Then, with the help of a friend, turn the cart to its upright position. Attach the door handles to the doors by placing the bolts through the keyholes. Then slide the handles up into place and tighten securely. With the help of a friend, place the grill body assembly on the assembled cart frame. Align the brackets to the reattached bolts on the cart frame and push the grill body toward the front of the grill and lock into place. Then tighten the reattached bolts. Remove the three bolts, then attach the left side table front panel to the side table using the three pre-attached bolts. Make sure to tighten the bolts securely. Place 2D batteries into the light battery compartment and slide the compartment into the sleeve under the left side table front. Attach the light wire to the light switch. Place 2D batteries into the motor battery compartment and slide the compartment into the sleeve under the left side table back. Attach the side burner front panel to the side burner assembly using the 3 pre-attached bolts. Then tighten the bolts securely. Remove the front bolt from the left side of the cart frame assembly as shown. Place the 4 keyholes on the left side table over the 4 pre-attached bolts on the left side of the cart frame assembly and slide toward the back of the grill to lock. Then tighten the bolt securely and reinsert the bolt to fasten the front panel. Remove the front bolt from the right side of the cart frame assembly as shown. Place the 4 keyholes on the side burner assembly over the 4 pre-attached bolts on the right side of the cart frame assembly and slide the side burner assembly toward the back of the grill to lock. Then tighten the bolt securely and reinsert the bolt to fasten the front panel. Remove the cotter pin from the side burner bracket so the side burner can move freely. Insert the side burner valve assembly through the holes in the side burner front panel. Then firmly seat the valve nozzle into the burner venturi. Rotate the burner valve assembly clockwise to lock into place with the keyholes. Then tighten the pre-attached bolts. Place the side burner control knob on the side burner valve stem. Then replace the cotter pin in the side burner bracket. Place the side burner grate on the side burner. Attach the side burner igniter lead wire to the electrode as illustrated. Place cooking grates on the support ribs directly above the heat distribution plates. Insert warming rack onto the brackets. Insert the grease cup into the grease tray, which is pre-installed on the back side of the grill. Make sure to slide the cup onto the tracks as illustrated. Slide the rotisserie motor onto the tracks of the motor bracket located on the back of the grill. Attach the lead wire coming from the grill body to the motor. Remove the igniter cap and insert one AA battery with the positive end of the battery toward the igniter cap. Then replace the igniter cap and make sure the igniter is working properly. Loosen the set screw and slide the grooved end of the sliding collar onto the spit rod. The end of the collar and the end of the rod should be aligned. Place one fork onto the spit rod with the prongs facing away from the sliding collar. Do not tighten the set screw at this time. Place the loaded spit rod onto the motor assembly and adjust the sliding collar to rest on the support bracket. Now you're ready to turn the rotisserie motor on.